Welcome to Beyond the Press channel.
Hello.
I'm Lauri.
And I'm Anni. And today we are going to build time machine.
Or to be more precise, we are going to test what happens for hourglass on high gravity environment. And we are also live on Twitch right now when we are filming. I'm not sure are we now when you are watching. But we are going to start weekly live stream on our Twitch channel, Hydraulic Press channel. And you can see how we make the videos. So instead of the short YouTube video, you can see the whole day of action when we do these things. Yeah, but back to the experiment. We don't have like artificial gravity field here. We are not there yet. So we have to do the next best thing and use cheating. And by cheating, we are going to mean centrifugal acceleration. So we are going to spin one of these really fast, and it's going to be exactly the same as high gravity for the hourglass. And I have cool idea how we are going to do that. Yeah, and I think this is a bit too large because we have to use the lathe. So instead of this, we are going to use this, but it's exactly the same. And this is also going to save a lot of time because this is 1 minute and this is 1 hour. So I think this is better. And I have pretty simple idea. I'm going to just put it here and tape it here. I think we need something also here. Otherwise it's going to like flop out. Yeah, that's so good. I think I'm going to cut these, otherwise they're going to flap when they spin. Yes, and now it's time for predictions. It's going to be 25 G's. When it spins there, 500 revolutions per minute. And what is, Anni, your idea? How fast is it going to run?
It will break.
Break?
Yeah.
Like here, spinning there?
Yeah.
No, it's not going to break. Okay. You have to guess again.
I don't know.
Four options. Same speed, faster, slower, not at all.
Not at all.
I'm going to say that it's going to go 20 times faster. Yeah, so I'm going to put it up here. So it's going to run on the this side, and then we are going to make it spin and see the right answer. Yeah, so everything is now ready. I have the hourglass there. Lathe is set for 500. Camera is set for 25 frames per second. So you are going to see at least something. And I think I'm going to spin it 10 seconds. And then we are going to look what happened. And then we are going to take also slow motion shots after this. But first we are going to just test what it does. Yeah, so here is the picture of that. And let's pray that it doesn't fly away. And it's all gone. I was right.
Oh,
it's all gone. It was much faster. That one 1/6 of the regular time. So there's your answer. In higher gravity, time runs faster if you are measuring with the time glass. If you are just measuring time, then it's actually slower on high gravity, but our glasses are going to be faster. Oh, this was so simple and clever idea. And on the Twitch chat, I think the most of the people said that it's going to be slower. So it's like, it's not easy thing to guess, but what is going to happen. Yeah, so I was right, or kind of right. It wasn't 20 times faster. It was about 6 times faster. It was actually, I think it was about 9 seconds when I looked from the footage. So it really goes much faster. But now we are going to film close-up shot with the high-speed camera. So this is again here. And all the sand is now on the inside, which is going to be like up in this case. And then I have the monochrome chronos here. So now we can see when it goes past there, what is going on with the sand. That's spinning. That's stopping. And that's stopping. And then we are going to look from here. Yeah, this is pretty good speed. I think we are going to see some stuff. Here it goes. Holy shit! It goes completely sideways. It doesn't go down at all. And there it comes again. It's like... it's hitting there. It's like only 1/4 of the way down and it already hits the side. That's really interesting. I think I'm going to zoom in more and get even higher frame rate so we can see even closer what's going on. Yeah, so now we have 8,000 frames per second and much smaller image. So we can see now more details how it's going to go. But first we have to, of course, like get the sand on the right side of the glass. So we are going to wait that, and then I'm going to put it spin. Yeah, that's really cool shot. You can see how it hits the side of the container, and then it goes straight down after that. That's super cool. And here it's almost full. I think I'm going to save this and then we are going to look like 4 seconds later how it's looking there. Yeah, so now we are here about 4 seconds later and let's try to find the hourglass. Dun, 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 dun. There it is. And it's almost empty. And now you can see that the, also the sand on the hourglass is like sideways. That's pretty weird because there is quite hard pull on the sand to make it like level, but it still stays like that. I found that really surprising. Yeah, but I think we are ready with this one and we are going to try the different type next. And this also survived. So we can do more experiments with this.
Your time machine 5 million was pretty good.
Hey, that's true, that's true. Hey!
Whoa!
Do you know the like rapper guys? They have the like clock here. It's like my version of this. Yeah, and then the next one. I have no idea how I'm going to mount this. But now since we already have results, we can take a bit more risk. So I think I'm going to just put it here. And if it flies, then it flies. I give 0% of chances of this staying here. I'm just going to check, is there anything that can break on the plane of death? I think no. Yeah, I think nothing is going to break. So if it stays here, that's interesting. If it doesn't stay, that's also interesting. So it's like good result.
Win-win.
Win-win. Nothing can go wrong. Holy shit, here we go. Didn't fly away. I cannot see shit. Let's wait, press on that. Let's wait for a while. Let's stop here. It's already gone.
What?
That was super fast. That's like, I think we spun it like 20 seconds. I have to check the high speed, what happened there. But the higher acceleration affects this one much more than the traditional one.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to see something here. It's already gone here.
What?
It's super fast. I'm on the way on when I try to look through the camera.
Yeah.
I think we have to do this again to get better high speed. But I checked this. Yeah, it's super fast. I go into the way. But we are going to do this again, and now I'm going to film just with this so we can see how fast it is. So here it starts. I put beginning there. And then I'm going to put the timestamp here. So this is minus 6.4 seconds. Four. Still almost full. 3.4 seconds. It's like halfway. Let's have a look on 1.4. So 5 seconds later.
Is it already empty?
Not. Is it almost empty, I think.
Hard to say.
Let's see. Now it's empty. So it's like, it's probably around 6 seconds. I'm going to save all of this. And I'm going to do the analyze on the computer. And you are going to know the right answer. Hey, time machine 5 million. Really works with this one. It was like 10 times, 8 times faster time. And with this, time runs 35 times faster than regular speed. Or actually the beads run here. I think the time doesn't care what these do. But it was still an interesting small experiment. And hope that you like it also. And the guys at Twitch stream also liked it. So if you want to see stuff like this, it was 3 hours of work to do this. So if you like to spend 3 hours watching us, then you should go check the Twitch channel.
Yeah.
Hydraulic Press channel, link is in description. Yeah, but that is all for today.
Thanks for watching.
And have a nice day.